The silence between two thoughts. This is, as Esther mentioned, a phrase I got from an Iranian friend of mine. And it refers to those moments when you suddenly go, hey, wait a minute. And you realize that you have to think about things differently. Now, in front of you is a picture, which I'm sorry I didn't print enough for everybody, so if you wouldn't mind sharing that. Right? This is painted about just under 400 years ago in Spain by an artist named Diego Velázquez. And no, this speech is not about art history. This painting is called La Mulata, or Young Mulatto Woman. If you take a look, brief look at it, you'll see a young girl is the center of the painting. She is in front of what looks like a kitchen table. There are pots and pans and implements. There's a clove of garlic down on the lower right there. And she's not looking at you. If you follow her gaze just a little bit, she's looking over towards her shoulder, and up in the upper left-hand corner is a window into another room where two men and part of a third are sitting at a table. It's interesting to note that this painting wasn't attributed to Velázquez until the early 20th century, and it wasn't until the 1930s when they cleaned it that this part of the picture even became apparent. This is the most important part of the picture. This isn't just a picture of a young girl working in a kitchen. If you have a better copy than I do, and I think you do, you'll notice that this picture is of a young black woman. It is probably painted from life. This is a real person. She was probably a slave, by the way, in Seville at that time, if she was black. But what is it that's going on over her shoulder? So even though it's not in the center, in fact, it's in the background of this painting, what's going on? Well, the subtext for this painting is based on a biblical story, and no, this speech is not about religion. But this depicts a particular event in the New Testament called the Supper at Emmaus. And it refers to a point in the New Testament where Jesus Christ had been crucified, he had risen from the dead, and he had met two of his disciples on the road who didn't recognize him. And they invited him to have dinner with him at this inn. And it was when they were breaking bread they suddenly recognized who this man was and what had happened. They had a silence between two thoughts as they suddenly were, wait a minute, this guy's alive again. How could this be? What I find interesting about this painting and why it speaks to me is because if you look at this girl, as she looks over her shoulder, towards the corner where those men are sitting, she's having one of those moments when she realizes the world is now different. She's sitting there going, wait a minute, that's the guy they killed a few days ago. How can he be walking around? Now, if you expand this beyond the religious iconography that you see in front of you, these are moments that happen to all of us. Not necessarily this big or earth-shattering, but they all happen. If you've ever had to lose a loved one, and probably everybody has at some point, the first time it happens, you realize the world is never the same after that. You suddenly realize that life is a little more precious. Your worldview has changed. You come to accept the fact that loss is part of life. The first time you fall in love, and you're in that giddy, crazy state of mind, and everything seems more beautiful for some reason, your view of the world has changed. You've had another one of these moments between two thoughts. They don't have to be that big. We have these things all the time. When you're doing something at work, there's a phrase that runs around that says the definition of insanity is to do the same thing over and over and over again and expect a different result. It's when you sort of wake up and go, wait a minute, maybe I should do this differently, that it's important. Now, the reason I bring this up, the reason I mention this, the reason I'm bringing it to you tonight is because I'm hungry for these little moments. I like having to change my mind. And I think we all should be like that. We should seek these moments out. They're going to come to us anyway. So we should make the most of them. Anything that broadens your horizons is a good thing. Anything that makes you look at the world a little differently is a good thing. I'll give you a small anecdote from my past. There was a time some years ago when I had to go to Africa to do a short project. And I was running around Ghana with this gentleman I met there named Peck. Great guy. And we were walking from one building to another. We didn't know what time it was. And Peck just yelled out to a young woman across the street. He said, sister, what time is it? And at that moment, I went, oh, I've heard sort of an African Americans or African Canadians refer to themselves as brother and sister. And I didn't know why they did that. And now I see, even though these people were transplanted, like this young woman, as slaves to North America, and they lost their names, their religion, their language, their identities, they didn't lose all of their culture. That little piece. So they went, oh, I see where that comes from. That was sort of broadened my horizons a little bit, expanded my mind. These little things happen all the time. So what I'd like to ask the members to do is just remember this picture. You can keep the copy if you don't have to fight for it. I don't think that's going to happen. Or remember this phrase, the silence between two thoughts and what it means. And just go forward from the meeting tonight and think, yes, I want these little moments that change the way I think about these things. I want these little moments that change my worldview. Because I think they're valuable, and I think that you won't regret trying to think this way. Thank you.